What up, guys? Welcome to Sonage here, playing some more WWE 2K15 Universe Mode. We're on episode 84, week 32 of ECW, and NXT was a little weird, to say the least. I don't know if I didn't feel like I was playing at my full potential, and there was a lot of matches that I kind of wish I could redo over. But, you know, there's times to redo things, and there's times for other things to happen. And with me, you know, fucking up, at the same time, you get a chance to redo things and not redo things, but you have a chance to undo things by making better matches next time or whatever, or setting up right things. Regardless of all that, I don't know if Kevin Owens and Styles Strong are ready to face each other again for the championship. I mean, we almost saw Kevin Owens get owned this week earlier on NXT. I mean, he got big booted right out of the air. It was out of control, but he almost lost it. Luckily, with the resiliency that he has, stayed in it and beat Styles is strong. But that's just the tip of the iceberg there. We also saw Sami Zayn being completely decimated by Scott Mercury. I mean, barely getting any offense, and Scott Mercury was just throwing kicks, throwing punches, everything he had at Sami Zayn, and finished it. Then we also saw probably one of the two other important matches, as Baron Corbin got defeated on NXT by Xavier Woods for the Intercontinental Championship. So Xavier Woods is now the new Intercontinental Champion, so you'll be seeing him a little more often. And then we also saw ACH and Kofi Kingston just fucking go at it. It was a really great match. I almost shit my pants because I didn't want to lose it. And luckily I came out the winner, but it was crazy, man. It was fucking crazy. But with that, there's more to come here tonight. So, going into ECW presenting TLC this weekend, this Sunday, on pay-per-view, these matches are lined up to be pretty good for what's going on. So, up first, Mark Henry, Batista, and Rob Van Dam taking each other on in a Triple Threat Extreme Rules match. Holy shit, we haven't seen Mark Henry in a while. We haven't seen Batista in singles action often, and Rob Van Dam usually just, you know, the guy who usually doesn't get pinned, but he loses the match nonetheless. We'll see if anything changes here tonight on ECW. Our second match, the Hardys make their debut versus the Usos, debuting here on ECW. Now, the Usos are not on ECW, but they're going to be taking on brothers, the Hardys, to be exact. Matt Hardy makes his debut here tonight as he teams up with his brother, Jeff. So I can't wait to see what the hell those two got going on. But we'll find out soon enough. Our third match, Kevin Nash takes on Finn Balor. I don't know if you noticed, but Finn Balor has a little more color than he used to have before, and that's because it's a newer, updated model of Finn Balor. So be prepared to enjoy the hell out of that. I can't wait to see what he looks like, because I still haven't seen him in full yet. Samoa Joe also gets a makeover here as he takes on The Big Show in our fourth match of the night. Cannot wait to see who the hell gets smashed in this match. Then the Women's Championship is on the line. Like I said on NXT, and if you missed it, I am splitting up the Divas again, like I had the first month of my Universe Mode, having the Women's Championship back on ECW. So Natalya, Tamina Snuka, Nikki Bella, and Paige will be taking each other on in a Fatal 4-Way Extreme Rules match to determine the new vacant Women's Champion. Dean Ambrose takes on CM Punk in another Extreme Rules match for our semi-main event of the night. Can't wait to see what the hell these two got going on. Punk has been on a spree as of late, but Dean Ambrose wants to end that. We'll see if Dean Ambrose can do it, but that's later on tonight. In our main event, Tyler Black takes on Jack Swagger. These two are heading into TLC for the championship. The championship is not on the line here tonight, but a win for either of these men will take them big time going into TLC. So I can't wait to see what the hell goes on there. But up first, Mark Henry, Batista, and Rob Van Dam shake each other on Extreme Rules match. Don't you dare click away. Playing as Batista here as I take on Rob Van Dam and Mark Henry. Mark Henry just ran over there, clothesline. And Batista already showing off here. You got two big behemoths here, trying to do something big, but Batista just amazingly strong.
Rob Van Dam, what a story this man has.
Well, there's no love lost between these two.
Whoa.
These guys simply want to tear each other apart. A sharp kick.
Right now, Rob Van Dam has the control of this match here. Oh, for a moment at least. And he got it back. Batista throwing weapons into the ring.
Now with a chair.
I don't know if that's going to help him or not.
These no DQ matches are so dangerous.
Oh, the brute force of that punch from Mark Henry.
Jaw jacking drop kick.
Oof.
And we're going back between the ropes.
Oh no.
Nobody can play the power game like Batista.
Close. I mean, he's going big. Batista going for a clothesline. And oh, Mark Henry reversed it, but only for a moment. The low blow here, it is all legal here in this Extreme Rules match.
Oh, back to the head.
DT taking him down.
Hey, he can't do this.
Oh, yes he can. This is no disqualifications.
What a reversal. Look at the power.
Looks like Mark Henry's setting for something big. Oh.
This could be over quick.
Rob Van Dam just lucky saved. Batista here, what the hell? Batista's going for, oh! Just elbow drop that ladder pretty much. Rob Van Dam seeing at the last second. I have never seen a reversal like that before. That was pretty cool.
Beautiful moonsault. What rotation.
Shows an innovative style of Rob Van Dam to reverse that, but not only reverse it, but throw his opponent across the ring here onto the ladder. That was pretty fucking cool.
RVD will drop a split leg moonsault on you in the blink of an eye. And good luck recovering from that.
You can
see the pain shoot through the superstar's body off that slam. Things are up.
Now Mark Henry beating the hell out of Rob Van Dam here.
And this is going to return to the ring. Oh man, that could very well be the end of it right there. He's got him up. And that was broken up before it could land.
Ooh, big time clothesline, taking him down. Oh, drop toe hold there by RVD. RVD trying to turn the big man over, or at least I thought he was.
He was able to reverse that.
Oh no! Oof! Catching the legs on that ladder there. Now Batista with the mounted punches, laying him out on Rob Van Dam's fucking head. Oof! Batista now showing the strength again here. Oh, on that ladder again. Batista just, oh. Lisa for a second was on a wreck mode here. Oh, and he. Big time, big boot. Oh, taking him down. Oh no 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 no! Batista! Oh, gosh!
Flesh on that ladder.
Oh no, Batista!
Batista looking to ignite the.
He wants to end this here, Batista with a power bomb. Jeez! That could be it. That may be it right there. One, two, three. Oh, and Rob Van Dam somehow, someway kicks out of that. Mark Henry now. Oh my gosh, catching the foot on that ladder. But the strength of Mark Henry is what's amazing here at this point. Mark Henry needs to get back in the ring because Rob Van Dam looks like he's setting up for the. Oh, it looked like for a moment that he was setting up for the. Frog splasher. Oh no 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 no. Oh my now on that fucking chair.
Oh, and did you hear the
oh for the legs now.
How much more?
What we've
how
seen from Mark Henry as of late, he's had an injury.
This is unreal.
As of recently. Kinda why he's been out of action for a while. Oh, Batista using that ladder to his advantage here, and that's what he needs to do. Oh, going for that corner spear. Could have damn taken his head off. Batista's still standing up somehow, someway.
askew there.
Reversal.
That move perfectly.
Batting him out the way here. That's a smart idea by Batista here.
What a powerful counter by Mark Henry.
Mark Henry got reversed there. Big time reversal by DDT. Another one.
Big boot. How much longer he's going to be able to go. We're in the midst of a WWE no disqualification match.
Oh, right in the back of Rob Van Dam here.
Let me remind everybody, there are no countouts. These competitors can stay out here as
I don't know what the hell Mark Henry is thinking here.
No, not at all. Oh, this is dangerous right here.
Oh.
He took too much time. And
Rob Van Dam feeling froggy here. Oof. Oof. Fucking A.
Are you kidding me?
Look at this. Okay, I don't think Mark Henry will do anymore. I mean, Mark Henry's throwing his biggest, almost his biggest moves at him right now. Oof. Oof. And again,
Mark Henry is taken. And he gets back in the ring. Nowhere to go. Great hold being applied.
Batista breaking out there. Oh, stepped on the foot. Oh, oh, the chop to the chest. May do it right there.
Defense by Rob Van Dam.
All right, Dan, feeling a little froggy here. I don't know how much that will help. Oh, Batista breaks it up at two there. Even the referee got a little hit there.
Definitely been done. Now it may just be a matter of time.
I was going to try to intercept him with the ladder. That would have been a fucking amazing, but I threw it too early. I didn't know when he was going to jump.
Man, Rob Van Dam is just unstoppable right now. Oh, jeez. Right down on that ladder again.
Oh, no. Oh! Batista, oh, it's going for the Batista bomb there. Oh, and he just got thrown off by Mark Henry. The strength of Mark Henry is unbelievable. You think Batista's strong, and then you see something like that just tossing him like a child across the ring here. What the hell? Oh! Rob Van Dam with a reversal here. This match is out of control. Enziguri.
And that one hit with the force of a big ring.
Oh!
Huge shot to Batista.
Moonsault and Van Dam got it, but Van Dam needs to get some stamina back. He looks like he's running on fumes here, but so does all three of the other two men here. The fuck?
He thinks he, and there's the breakup.
Batista still finding a way out of it.
This could do it. And he breaks the hole. A few seconds longer, and this match would have been over. Look out. Watch it.
Oh.
Oh, man, that was a sick thud when he hit
Batista going for the Batista bomb. He just took the big man out. Now he's going for the smaller guy. Oh, my gosh.
Batista bomb.
But Batista has nothing else left in him. Somehow, some way. He has to get himself back into this. Mark Henry knows that this could be over here. Going for the pin. Referee. Mark Henry not paying attention here. One, two. Oh, and Rob Van Dam kicks out. Some way, somehow. I don't know how the fuck he did that shit. That was crazy. Oh. Rob Van Dam with a reversal. Oh. Going for the pin again here. Oh, and he just hit the hell out of Rob Van Dam. Somehow Rob Van's still standing here and reverses it somehow as well. Oh. clothesline taking him out.
Moving on pure instinct now. Oh, going to the top, high risk.
This is bad for every man in this match here.
Boy, he is really tired now. He wasted too much time on that one.
Van Dam going up for something big here. Oh my gosh, he just tossed him across the ring here. Van Dam. Van Dam now has an advantage here, but also Mark Henry is back up as well.
Great offense by Rob Van Dam.
This guy. We're avoiding the punches by Batista here.
Uh-oh. Look where he's going again.
Oh! Laid him out with the chair. That could be it. 1, 2, 3. And Batista just clacked him right across the skull with that chair. Full power and all. I don't care who you are. You get hit like with that, a chair like that by Batista, you're more than likely not going to get it for a while. Right in the fucking head and ended it. Holy shit. What a match. This one went on a little longer than I wanted it to, but shit happens.
Here is your winner, representing Evolution, the Animal Batista.
Batista just fucking killing it, man. Holy shit. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Anyway, guys, up next, the Hardys team up for the first time ever in my universe mode as they take on another brother tag team in the Usos. We'll find out who wins this match up next. Hardys, Usos, get ready for it. Playing as Matt and Jeff, the Hardy Boys here, as they take on Jimmy and Jey Uso. Oh my gosh, Matt Hardy already with his first few punches being thrown here. And that's what Matt Hardy has to do, is start something big here. Oh, Uso picking him up. Oh, Matt reverses it. Oh,
the speed of tornado.
Matt Hardy fucking already in the match of throwing punches.
Wow, Jimmy Uso just timed that perfectly.
Oh,
and he dodges that one.
Oh, Matt Hardy, look at this. Different style than you see from Jeff here. As much as Jeff gets praised here, you gotta give the one who actually wrestles more credit at times, Matt Hardy. Oh, and Jimmy Uso already there with that suplex neckbreaker there. That was fucking crazy.
And the knuckles connect. And the boot connects with the abdomen.
Clothesline taking him down.
He almost took his head off with that lariat.
Oh, a punch right to the face. I'm not sure if that helps out the likability of these two teams here. Two very face teams for sure. But that punch right there may change everything here. Oh, that was cool. Hardy punched him in the back of the head there, stunning him a little more. No. Matt Hardy going to the top here. I don't know if Uso sees it coming. Oh! Now you saw Uso try to run away from that to his tag team partner. And Matt pretty much said, no, that's not happening. Look at this. Matt Hardy just... Oof!
Comes up with an effective counter. Dodges to the side of that one. Heads up!
Look at this! Whoa! Matt Hardy flying, and they usually seem to go for springboards, but that was cool. That was definitely different.
You know when Jey Uso makes his famous climb?
Matt Hardy going up, coming down, leg drop. Not with a lot left in him.
After all of these shots to the head.
Oh my gosh! Oh! Jey Uso returning the favor here for what Matt Hardy did earlier, and somehow, some way, these two teams seem to hate each other already.
Great reversal by Icon.
Oof. Big time explosive dropkick.
Oh, back to the head.
Oh,
back to the temple.
Oof.
He was one step ahead on that one. Knocked into the middle of next week.
Monkey flip.
Seeing Jey Uso soar through the air like that is simply amazing. The top rope splash is a move Jey perfected many years ago, as you can tell by how many opponents he's put away with it.
Jeff Hardy going up. Moonsault.
Uh-oh. It might be time to run.
Drop kick missed.
That move perfectly.
Oh, low super kick there. Uso was feeling something there, and he kind of lost it. But now, Jeff Hardy fighting back here. Oh, you see his legs get caught up there. That could be it. Oh, that could be it right there. This is the kind of tag team I like to see here. Fucking fast-paced fucking shit. Like, I don't know. I don't know what it took. I guess it just took this kind of match like this to actually get something started here.
Wow, Jimmy Uso just timed that perfectly. Nice reversal there.
Jimmy Uso flung into the corner there. Jeff Hardy whisper in the wind, and he got all of it.
There's a nice reversal.
But somehow, some way, Jimmy Uso still fighting in this one here. Roll up here, it could be it. Referee. Whoa, and Jey Uso saving the pin there. Jeff Hardy still fighting, still finding a way in this.
Oh! Oh, out of nowhere!
Oh, his elbow to the face! Definitely no joke.
Perfectly.
Big time clothesline.
What a shot!
Oh, boot to the face!
And he dodges that one.
Big time suplex over the rope here, and he got him.
Ducked back in the ring.
Crowd definitely feeling this match here. Definitely feeling this match. Oh. Matt saving it. What the hell? Matt Hardy? No way. Matt going to the top here. Whoa.
Oh no, Jey saw that one coming. And he does it one more time. Three.
Oh, fucking A.
Oh man, I think that cracked the ring post.
The Hardy's playing hard right here. Oh my gosh, alley-oop. Oh! His face had to bounce right off that. There's no way that he's not hurt, battered, and beaten here.
Uh-oh, look at this.
Oh!
And there's the arrogance of Icon.
Oh, and he just landed on his brother there, but still finding a way in this. Oh, and a forearm there. This match is out of control here.
He's not going to give up, but man, this has been physical.
Oh,
trying to get something going for his partner.
He's two beating the hell out of this team here.
Uso is going to return to the ring. Jey Uso with a great offensive show.
What the hell is going on? This match out of control. Big time elbow drop to the chest.
This guy's just getting worn out.
Somehow, some way, Hardy's getting up. Both of them actually. Oh, somehow the Usos are still up as well. Taking more damage in this match than anything. Now back outside. Jeff Hardy. Oh!
He might need to change his drawers after that one.
Dropkick missed.
Getting out of that one.
Reverse the side effect that I think Matt Hardy was going for there. Oof. Ah. Matt going for it again. This is why it's such a two teams like this are so damn good. Oh, ran right into the forearm.
He's going for it all. This doesn't end in the count out, and he gets tossed back in the ring.
Jeff going up again here. This can't. I don't know if this is good. Whoever this is good for here. Big time splash to the back of Jey Uso. My gosh, this match is out of control. Probably one of the more exciting tag team matches though. I have a lot of them. Tag team going for something here. And he got him. No detail these two are thinking here now. Whoa, big time face buster. Hardy going up to the top, but can he reach it from here? That's the thing, can he reach Jey Uso? He'll go for it anyway, he'll try. Oh, and he was on Tony and he missed it.
I'm wondering if he has something in his eye. And he finally gets out of the ring. Look at him out there, reaching for the tag. He can't wait to get back in the mix.
Somehow, some way, these two teams are still going here. Oh! What the fuck happened to Hardy?
Boy, he was able to reverse and get out of that.
Oh, super kick, kicking his head clean off. Man, Matt Hardy may be knocked the hell out here. Referee, one. Oh, and Jeff saves it. Oh.
Damage has definitely been done. Now it may just be a matter of time.
Going for another kind of move that the Hardys will go for. It seems like going for something big again. Whoa, spin cycle. They got it. Oh, boot to the face again on Jimmy Uso. They're going for it. Looks like Jeff Hardy was going for the pin, but now he's switching. It seems like he's switching it up here.
Look at this.
Alley-oop. Face buster on the ropes. Jeff needs a tag in Matt for sure. And so does the Usos. Man, that was fucking crazy. Somehow, some way. Oh. Here we go.
He's measuring.
Side effect, he got him.
He's begging for it.
He got him. Twist of fate.
There's the cover. Can he do it?
What the fuck? He just let go of the pin. Oh.
Cannot hide the blood. He's taking a beating. And again, Icon going to the top rope. And that's a shot that could drop a grizzly.
How the hell is this guy still going, man? I think I grabbed him as I was running across.
And there's the speed of Tornado.
Nice. Oh my gosh. Oh, reverse that neck breaker there. Big time monkey flip. Oh my gosh, I need that face. Uso, Jay may have this match here at this point. Going for something big, it seems. Uh-oh. Dropkick missed.
Getting out of that one.
Oh, missed the super kick.
Looks like somebody wants back in this match.
Going for something else here, it seems. Or maybe the same thing, I don't know. Whoa. Okay, that was kind of lackluster, for sure.
He's gonna take another chance.
Fuck it, I'm going for the twist of fate. God damn it. Here we go!
That's it. He's done.
Oh!
There's the tag, and he's ready to.
And now the Usos tag find a way to get past him. Oh! Oh man! Oh, big time headbutt taken down Jeff here. I'm sorry this match is really long, but god damn it, something has to give. Oh, dragon screw. Okay, or not. Whoa.
He gets out of trouble there. Hey, wait a minute. What's he doing here?
Over the pin, referee, referee. One, two, no.
And again, Icon going to the top rope.
Jeff doesn't have a lot in him. He's going for something big. Oh, and he just avoided it. Just threw him down pretty much. The Uso now. Oh, big time. Oh, big time Samoan drop. And that could be it. That definitely could be it for sure. Referee. And Matt Hardy breaks it up. Oh, side suplex there. Again, another big boot. Reversal by, oh, Jimmy Uso. Oh, back kick there.
Jimmy Uso,
Jimmy Uso now throwing him over the top here. Oh, and he caught him. Jimmy Uso flying here. Jimmy Uso simply flying. And somehow, some way, Jeff Hardy's still in this. Going for the alley-oop again, and no, Jimmy Uso with the reversal.
Back into the ring now. Man, Jimmy Uso is in a bad way. Ooh, that did it.
Oh, a punch to the back of the head. And that could be it right there. Another one. Just stunning him again here. Oh, right. Disrespectful. Disrespectful punch. Oh, and Jeff Hardy with a reversal. Reversal by Hardy. Close. Drop kick. Taking him down here. Jeff Hardy going to the middle rope here. And, oh, and he got him with whatever the hell that was. He was supposed to be, I guess it was a fucking Hurricanrana. Or something going on. Alley-oop face buster again. And somehow Jimmy Uso still somehow, some way. Body splash. Referee. And Matt Hardy saves it again. Clothesline taking him down. These two teams do not want to disappoint anyone here at this interior tonight. Going for another one of those tag team maneuvers. Ah, this is boring as fuck. Sorry for this long tag team match, guys, but somebody has to win this here. Matt Hardy. Whoa, Matt Hardy flying. I've never seen a move like that.
And now he's back out on the
I've never seen him at this capacity here. Going for another one of those side effects, and he got him. Referee, one, two, and that. Ah, you motherfucker. It just takes so long to get in the ring. So long. Oh, Matt Hardy again. Twist of fate. You can see Jimmy trying to go for his tag team partner here. Just not in the right place at the right time by any means. What the hell is Matt going for here? No way. No way! Moonsault! Dropkick to the back. Matter going again. Oh, and Uso moves out the way. Set up for that super kick. Oh, he missed it. He missed all of it. Reversal by Uso, though. Again, these two teams just cannot find a way to end this one here. Too damn good. Too damn good. Oh, a kick to the gut there. Jey Uso not fucking around here.
And there's the speed of Tornado.
No way! Oh my gosh! Twist of fate! Twist of fate! Kick to the head! That could be it right there. Referee! Referee! End this. One, two, three, and holy shit! A win for both these men here. What a fucking match. Holy shit! You talk about tag team action. Mind you, this is only the second match of the night. This can be a long ECW, kids. I wish the game wasn't so stiff when it came to tag team matches, because we could have a phenomenal match. I didn't even know he could do that. I just threw him off the rope. I was like, he probably has that. Whoever made this guy probably gave him that. Whoever made this guy is fucking amazing, first of all, because Matt Hardy looks amazing. He looks amazing. I thought Jeff looked really good when he came out. Matt looks amazing. I'll change the music. Don't worry, guys. Next week or whatever. What a fucking match, dude. That was fucking crazy. The Usos are not giving in at all, man. It shows that the Usos want to win this one just as much as the Hardys do. But the Hardys, legendary tag team in the business, with another victory under their belt. Anyway, guys, up next, Kevin Nash takes on Finn Balor. Finn Balor's been on a roll as of late. But Kevin Nash is ready to stomp over that roll. He's ready to put some water in the way of that roll. We'll find out who wins this match up next. Singles competition, Kevin Nash, Finn Balor. Don't you dare click away. Playing as Finn Balor here, you can see there's a new attire, a new look, a new everything. And this is what he may need to do to get a win here tonight over Kevin Nash, is have the feeling, before you even get thrown into a match, the feeling that you get going into a match can be just enough for you to get a win or victory, a victory here. But Kevin Nash not a small man to throw around. Now, we saw Finn Balor defeat Luke Harper a week back, I believe. And Finn Balor came out on top there. But we also saw Kevin Nash defeat Luke Harper. I mean, both these men have defeated him in recent weeks. But Kevin Nash took a beating, and I mean a beating, from Luke Harper and still came out on top. And who's to say he can't do that here tonight? Oh, knee to the chest there. Oh, forearm shot there. I don't know why Finn Balor is being booed, but whatever. Oh! I'll change that, don't worry, guys. It is a new Finn Balor model altogether, so it's like a new wrestler and everything. So I had to like get him back in the bracket and all that shit. Which kind of sucks, because I wish you could just continue, but it's a new superstar, so what are you going to do? Regardless of all that, good looking fucking car. I like the new update and all that shit like that. Really good. Finn Balor. Oh, kick to the face there. Welcome to ECW, people. We just came off an amazing, and I mean amazing, fucking tag team match. I mean, those two teams did not want to go away. The Hardys, oh my gosh, and Kevin Nash eating those punches. Look at this. Lift and reverse. DTE. Got him. But he just came off a crazy-ass tag team match. And a rope break. Stars looking for a victory, looking to build momentum. What the fuck was that? I don't know what I was thinking. Anyway, let's move. Finn Balor. Feeling it here. Kid's feeling it. He's going off the ropes. Flying onto... Whoa! And Kevin Nash playing Finn Balor. And that was amazing. Simply amazing. Now Kevin Nash throwing the damn near dead weight back into the ring here. Finn Balor trying to get himself back up.
And this is going to return to the ring.
Finn Balor again, those elbows to the corner.
He's heading back up.
Now going up to the top again.
Oh my God.
Knee drops, missed.
Bam.
Forearm shots. Tossing him over the top rope there. Kevin Nash, the strength here. The strength, not only the strength, but the experience. Much as such an older wrestler than Finn Balor. Finn Balor has gained a lot, and I mean a lot of skills in being in Japan, being in the European areas, the territories, all that shit. But Kevin Nash has been there before. Finn Balor's hardly been even born, barely. No way! No way! Referee in a rope break.
But he got right down to business when he eliminated Jack Swagger. Personally, I don't think that's the last time we'll see the big man surprises as a Rumble participant.
Oh, missed it. Oh, again.
Reversed it. Good move there.
Oh, and he missed it again. Big time swinging neckbreaker by Kevin Nash. Now Kano feeling it here. Big time sidewalk slammerama. Going for the pin here. Is it enough? And only a one count. And barely even that. Kevin Nash feeling it though.
Countered by the Prince.
I don't know why they're booing Finn Balor for it. It's fucking weird. Oh my gosh, Kevin Nash. Oh shit. No! And Finn Balor kicks out again. Finn Balor upset now.
Wow, King. I didn't think we would see this. Talk about defying the odds. The roof's gonna blow off this place. Well, that didn't work.
Oh!
Kevin Nash is taken down. Man, you could tell Nash wasn't expecting that.
I really don't think Nash was ready for what the hell was going on here. I don't know if he's ready for this either. Another one! Kevin Nash just got thrown for a loop here, going for the double foot stomp, coup de grace, and that could be it for Kevin Nash. We'll find in a second here. 1, 2, 3, and Finn Balor with a victory over Kevin Nash, but an amazing, amazing, amazing match. It seemed like Kevin Nash had that at the end there, just with a comeback. And at times, Kevin Nash really just had the match in the bag. I mean, Finn Balor was going for his biggest move here, or one of his biggest moves, and you'll see this in a second. Finn Balor feeling it. Finn Balor feeling so fucking well. Look at him, just ready, poised and ready. He bounced off the back rope there, coming back, and Kevin Nash just threw him out the way. And that's what's smart about this man, is he can play you very well. But Finn Balor somehow, some way, came out victor.
We may be looking at the match of the year.
Yeah, I gotta change the all that shit. God damn it. Boom, dun, dun, dun. Boom, dun, dun, dun. Either way, Finn Balor with a victory here. Holy shit.
Finn Balor.
He gets a big victory here tonight. Love him or hate him, that was an incredible match.
Anyway, guys, up next, Samoa Joe takes on the Big Show. Big Show got a reskin as well. Samoa Joe got a reskin as well. Let's see if he can take on the Big Show. Playing at Samoa Joe here as I take on the Big Show. Mind you this, these two took each other on last week. Oof. These two took each other on last week to find out who would be the new, number one contender for the ECW World Heavyweight Championship. Neither of these men won. It was Jack Swagger. That's why Jack Swagger will be taking on Tyler Black at ECW TLC. But mind you this, one of these men going into this match, they have a reason. There's a reason why both these men want this so much. And again, Samoa Joe going to the top again. Again, he was going for some kind of shoulder blocker or something there, and the Big Show cut him off. Big Show they're going to be thrown around too easily. We saw a couple weeks ago before this that Big Show had the chance of a lifetime to become champion once again, ECW World Heavyweight Champion, and Tyler Black took the easy way out here. And got himself disqualified to keep the championship, which led Big Show, Samoa Joe, and Samoa Joe, Big Show, and Jack Swagger. They led him into a triple threat match. Samoa Joe going to the top again and again. Who is not his kind of style. But you might have to switch it up when it comes to the Big Show. Big Show not easily going to be able to throw around so too easily. Going for something big, and no, Big Show cut him off. Oh, those punches. That was fucking nasty. Look at this. Oh my gosh, Emmaflosion. Oh, and reversed by the Big Show. Look at this. Look at the strength of the Big Show. Oh my gosh. Just toying around with Samoa Joe here. Big Show feeling it here. Oh, showstopper. You talk about a showstopper for sure. And no, only Samoa Joe kicks out at zero there. Oh, and that may be it. That definitely may be it right there. And again, Samoa Joe kicks out at two. Oh. I don't know how he just took a punch to the head and ate it. And somehow Samoa Joe upset. Big Show knows this. Taking his time. Throwing the momentum off here. Oh, and Big Show cuts him off. Big Show saw it coming and went for a reversal there right into the face of Samoa Joe. Big Show now taking advantage of this match. This is what he needs to do. Oh, stomping onto the chest of Samoa Joe here. Oh! Ooh! Big Show just tossing. Oh, the big man across. Mind you, Samoa Joe's no small man, and Big Show's easily able to throw him across the ring here. Oh, stomped to the midsection here. Samoa Joe trying to get up. Really can't do much here. You're going versus the Big Show, and Big Show gets his hands on you. It's pretty much over at that point. Look at this. Again, just showing the strength that he has here. Go for the pin. And again, Samoa Joe kicks out. It's been so physical. Ooh. The damage is definitely done. Double feet to the face there. Doing whatever it takes to win. Samoa Joe going up again. And he might not want to do this to right now when you have so much at risk, Joe, but he's gonna go for it anyway. Heads up! What a huge move. I don't know why they didn't hit, it just tapped Big Show on the shoulder and shit. But Big Show again here, and again, Samoa Joe kicks out. Again, those feet to the face. And again, Big Show reverses it. This is the night of reversals for sure. Oh, foot to the chest there. Oh, it's a Enziguri.
Oh, back to the head, back to the temple.
Another big time reversal by the Big Show.
He was one step ahead on that one.
Drop kick. Oh, taking him down. Samoa Joe. Oh.
Back into the ring now.
Samoa Joe showing off like he's won the damn thing already.
A little showboating going on here. Trying to get under his opponent's skin with this one. And this is going to return to the ring.
And Zaguri taking him down. Big Show upset. I don't think Samoa Joe really gives a hell at this point. Oh my gosh.
He's looking at it.
Samoa Joe trying to set up here. Samoa Joe trying to set up for sure. And he got him. And he got him. Rear naked choke. And he has it locked in. Hikulkina clutch. Hikulkina clutch is locked in. Hikulkina clutch is locked in. And Big Show has nothing else to do but to tap here. And it changed his thing too. God damn, people don't do entrances. I know that it's not important. Like, the most important part is the wrestler and the moves. But, geez, that this music is highly annoying. I mean, Big Show's beating the fuck out of Samoa Joe this whole match. Samoa Joe with a comeback there. Just choking him out. I don't like this one because it takes too long to go to the... I like the way the ending, but it takes too long to set up. Like, he's choking him standing and just... does all this, but the other one that Dolph Ziggler has, it chokes you out. Like, you fall instantly with him. This will take too damn long.
Here is your winner, Samoan Joe.
What a big win here tonight. Absolutely. Whenever you get a win after a match like this, it's big.
Samoa Joe with the victory here. Holy shit. I think it looks a lot better than the other one. For sure. The other one looked too... didn't look fat enough for me. I don't know. It was crazy. Anyways... up next, mind you, we have 3 matches to go here tonight. Tamina, Natalya, Nikki Bella, Paige for the vacant Women's Championship. That's up next. Extreme Rules Fatal 4-Way. One girl's going to come out as the victor. We'll find out who that is when we return to ECW. Playing as Paige here in this Fatal 4-Way match. Nikki wasn't paying attention, got dropped on her neck there. Now Natalya on the other side. Oh.
Hey, oh. Does that remind you of your last date? Oh,
whoa. These girls are gonna be able to easily get thrown around. We have 2 former champions here. Take each other on in the middle of the ring here, Natalya and Tamina. Nikki Bella, the first women's champion here on ECW back in the first few months of ECW.
Paige using her feet right there.
Now Paige beating the hell out of fucking Nikki here. Paige is very fast when it comes to getting in this ring and getting out of the ring. Very adept when it comes to getting in the ring. Nikki Bella very slowly becoming a student of the game. As annoying as she may be, she's very good in the ring. Natalya practically being born a wrestler here at this point. Paige suplex. But it may take a little bit more out of Paige than it did the Nikki Bella there. You can see Nikki getting right back up here. Paige getting weapons.
What a reversal. Not much the official can do right now. This is a no disqualification match.
Oh, look at this. Look at this.
Oh. Natalya is taking complete and total control of this match. Now, I don't get that.
Paige breaking it up.
If I was in a match like this, I'd want my opponents to get as worn down as quickly as possible. She's hooked. Hold it up. End over end.
Oh, snap suplex. DDT by Tamina there. Oh, Tamina just reversing whatever the hell Paige throwing at her. Clothesline, though, getting right back up. Showing her, trying to show some dominance that she may have in this match. But if anyone's really dominant in this match, I'd say it'd be Tamina Snuka. Oh, clothesline taking her out, too. Oh, double axe handle being reversed by Tamina. Dropkick taking her down, though. Reverse DDT by Nikki Bella. Tamina again trying to just beat the hell out of Tamina with that move there. Jeez. And again. Oh. Reverse.
Rolling out of harm's way. Smart strategy there.
You gotta watch Natalya. Natalya may be the fucking chosen one here in this match, the one that the fans are definitely have as a favorite here in this match.
Oh, and did you hear the impact? Oh, the flesh. Look at the welts.
Paige not fucking around with that table.
Well, going to the top, high risk.
It wouldn't be the first time these girls do something crazy here.
The opportunity.
Watch it.
No way.
This kind of damage she can take. Incoming.
Oh my gosh, and she just put Natalya through a table here, and Natalya right back up. I think Paige took more damage than Natalya did.
Every week in that ring and on Total Divas. But to come back from an injury like that, one that almost ended your career, I mean, that says it all. Well, that and twin magic. Nikki Bella doing a
clothesline,
turning that around.
And Tamina loses her vertical base.
Yeah, and she's going to be losing this match, too, if she's not careful.
Super kick, taking her down. Going for the legs now of Natalya. Oof.
Watch it. Ooh.
Super kick, taking down Nikki now. Going for the pin. Referee. One, two, and Tamina saves it.
Oh.
Planting her in the corner here. And there it goes. Tamina's feeling it. Bulldog taking her down. Nikki taking on Paige. Nikki taking on Natalya there. See if what she can, what kind of luck she can get. Oh.
Are you watching this, Michael Cole?
Oh man.
Oh boy, do I love this.
Tamina taking advantage of this at this point in the match.
Oh no. Here we go.
Oh man.
That'll take the wind out of your sails.
Paige breaking it up there.
Where does she get it from? How is she still going? She's got her. Oh, man.
Ooh. Tossing her over. Well, for the neck breaker is... Oh, Tamina.
She's having a hard time getting back to her feet after that.
Oh, back to the head. And this has got to be it. And she kicks out it.
Oof. Making the save again. Oh, and right here, Paige and Mee's taking the steal here. Paige and Mee taking the steal. Referee. One. And oh, and they girls both see it. They both see it there. Run right into that drop kick. Did Paige. Paige still trying to get herself back up here. Now all girls here. Oh my gosh, that backbreaker. That could be it. That definitely could be it right there. Holy shit.
Watch it.
German suplex. Referee. And Natalya, your first ever re-crowned women's champion here on ECW. I knew Natalya had to fucking win it because she's fucking... what the fuck did she get a German suplex from? But she kept hitting that shit, and I was like, is Tamina not going to reverse that shit? I knew it had to be either Natalya or I was going to just fucking dominate with Paige somehow, some way, but it was so hard to get Paige rolling. But now that that's over, now we can start crowning possibly new women's champion, or we just have girls go for it again and again. But either way, this is good because this makes you a lot better.
Here is your winner and new WWE Women's Champion, Natalya.
Natalya, women's champion. I don't know if she's been women's champion on WWE. I know she's been Divas champion. I don't know if she's been women's champion. But either fucking way, Natalya did it here tonight. Through all the carnage and everything that she's taken, she has become the new women's champion. You can see all the ruckus and all that shit over there at the bottom that she just practically fell over on. That fucking, those tables and all that shit. She's come through and has won the women's championship. But anyways, guys, there's two more matches to go in our 7-man event. Dean Ambrose takes on CM Punk. Get ready for it because it's up next, only on ECW.
Hey, do you see who's coming out? Be on your best behavior, Michael. Welcome. Have a seat right here.
Don't know what the hell Tyler Black is doing out here. Well, whatever the hell's going on. Yeah, I don't know if it was good for anyone here. Tyler Black scouting possible new challengers for his championship, but yet he has to worry about Swagger later on this weekend. Thing is, if Tyler Black can win this, he may be fighting one of these two. Oh, big time body splash there. Punk going for the pin here, but he knows Dean Ambrose a little too well, and he didn't put the full lateral on him. But he'd get into his mind, oh, it's just, it could be just as good as enough. Oh.
A nearly impossible feat to pull off, but the Windy City Warrior did it.
Dropkick reversed.
Dean Ambrose got out of that one.
Ambrose feeling it. Whatever the hell he's going for here. Reversal. This may be one of the biggest challenges that CM Punk has had to face as of late. Is the former ECW champ, longest reigning ECW champ, on my universe mode.
Dean Ambrose get out of that one.
Ambrose fucking flying around the ring. He's so damn fast. He's gained such an amazing... I don't know. He's changed his ways a lot since becoming champion. And now that he's not champion, it seems like he just wants to become champion one more time. Like, just do it again. And you know what I mean? It's hard to keep a guy like him down. And his stats don't really return. And you, as a champion, you get some like a little extra stats and shit like that. But it's hard to really keep someone like Dean Ambrose down, who's been champion for so long. I think he's been champion almost as long as Kevin Owens has been on NXT. Oh, reversal by Ambrose. And that is why both these men are going to have a big-time challenge ahead of each other here tonight, as these two take each other on. Big-time reversal by both men, but Punk getting it back there. Enziguri clipping Dean Ambrose. Flying right into Dean Ambrose. No. Oh! I love how I go perfectly angled into it, but I throw them. They're like, slide back in the ring. You're like, okay. Okay, game. Oof.
And what is probably no surprise to anyone, Dean Ambrose keeps his life away from WWE under lock and key. The native of Cincinnati, Ohio, loves the psychology of the human race.
Dropkick taking him down.
Even away from the ring, just to see how people will react. Watch it!
Oh my gosh, oh! I think Punk may have got a couple, I mean, if hit his thigh there on the step. Not exactly sure, but you can't think that CM Punk is in this fully at all.
And he gets back in the ring.
Both these men know how to play dirty, and they will do whatever they have to do to win this match. Mind you, outside, Tyler Black is watching. Tyler Black does not like Dean Ambrose, and Tyler Black does not like CM Punk. Oh! I didn't know you could reverse like that. That looked really cool. I didn't want to do that. Maybe, fuck. Dropkick. Falling onto the rope there is CM Punk. I wanted to bounce off the rope, but for some reason that wasn't going on. Dean Ambrose set up for that finisher. He could have it right here. Oh! I still don't know how to reverse that. Oh my gosh, Dean Ambrose could be trying to end this here. He could try to end this here. Reversal by CM Punk. CM Punk going for the GTS. And he may have it here. He may have it. Go to sleep.
Well, I gotta tell you, Dean Ambrose isn't enjoying this one bit, folks. A textbook reversal. Can he follow?
See, I mean, sorry, Dean Ambrose still fighting like everything belongs to him at this point. I don't know what that means. I just made that up out of nowhere. I'm sorry, people. Oh my gosh, and just now I get being punched in the face. But Dean Ambrose almost damn near cleared CM Punk here. Oh. Going for the dropkick to the knees. And CM Punk again. Reversal by Ambrose here. Big time reversal.
Able to break free.
Feeling it here again. Ambrose right back in it. Oh! Yeah, I don't know how to get out of this shit right here. Here we go. Never mind. I'm stuck in shit. I fucking can't grab this motherfucker. Oh!
Talk about CM Punk and historical moments from WWE, it has to be his famous pipe bomb from Monday Night Raw in 2011. Punk took that microphone and verbally mowed down everyone that he viewed as his opposition. Man,
oh,
some night.
Oh shit, CM Punk feeling it right here in front of Tyler Black, and this is the message that Punk wants to leave with Tyler Black here. Oh my gosh, here we go. Oh gosh, you talk about leaving a message. If Tyler Black can defeat Swagger, can CM Punk be the next opponent for Tyler Black's ECW World Heavyweight Championship? Or will it be Dean Ambrose? Dean Ambrose still has a chance here tonight. Oh! WWE changed, and the career of CM Punk changed forever. If you look at the events that transpired after that night, the summer of Punk, Money in the Bank versus... This could be it right here. Ambrose just got caught up with the Anaconda Vice. And I'd hate to see Ambrose lose this way, but it could end this way for Dean Ambrose. The pipe bomb was a full verbal assault against WWE, Vince McMahon, and his family. It was unreal. I mean, it was. I mean, he's pretty much sapping the energy. Actually cut off. Yeah. Out of CM Punk. And CM Punk, I mean, out of Dean Ambrose. And CM Punk now feeling it. Oh! You may not like CM Punk by any means, but you best believe this kid's gonna get it done somehow, some way. Swing neck breaker. This could be bad. This could be bad here. Going for it all. Big time elbow drop. Punk feeling, you can see the way he's hunched over here, and that could be it. Going for it. Oh, and Dean Ambrose reverses it. Oh, Dean Ambrose, big time DDT, and that could be it for CM Punk. He needs to get this win somehow, some way. No, and CM Punk just lost to Dean Ambrose. He could have beat Ambrose a long time ago, but CM Punk, the asshole that he is, trying to go for another finisher here. And that's why Dean Ambrose is a fighting champ for sure, regardless if he's holding the belt or not. Fighting champion. Champion fucking regardless of fucking wins or losses. Holy shit. And it, right here, you think that CM Punk would have had Dean Ambrose here with the Anaconda Vice. He came back with that shit so fast, I didn't even see it coming. I was like, oh shit. And I wish I reversed it because it would have been amazing, the amazing comeback too. Because I had all the momentum going and he just got thrown off there.
Here is your winner, Dean Ambrose.
What an incredible match. That one could have gone either way. Nobody has anything to be ashamed of in this one.
I'm a little upset that CM Punk lost that, because I easily had fucking Dean Ambrose's number, but when he went for that fucking, when he went for the fucking, the last GTS, I was like, shit. Once I saw the elbow, I was like, damn, I don't know the timing to reverse it back, because Ambrose grabs fucking quick. But regardless of all that shit happens, Dean Ambrose could see Dean Ambrose as champion again before this year is over. We'll find out later on in the year. But anyways, regardless of all that bullshit, up next, our main event, Tyler Black might as well stay there because he takes on Jack Swagger. Up next, only on ECW. Playing as Jack Swagger as I take on Tyler Black. We'll see what we can do. Last time these two faced each other for something really crazy was at ECW when they presented Hell in a Armageddon, or in the Hell in a Cell match, and Swagger pretty much had the match, but into the clinch, Jack Swagger going for it. Tyler Black had Jack Swagger pretty much tap out at the point where, I mean, all men were at this point where there was no way those men could have kept going there. And the submissions, it was all it needed to get the match over. And that's why Tyler Black is your ECW World Heavyweight Champion right now. Oh, double axe handle. Other one. Just beating the hell out of him. Oh, reversal. And right now, Swagger seems like he has all the momentum on his side. Regardless of Tyler Black really getting any reversals going on here. Seems like he has it all in the bag. Oh! Tyler Black taking advantage here with that low drop kick to the side of the head of Jack Swagger, and Swagger right back up. Oh! Reversal. These two will be taking each other on We two will be taking each other on at ECW TLC this Sunday. And I can only kind of fathom what the hell these two are going to do to each other in a TLC match. I mean, here they're in a singles match, but oof, again, Tyler Black taking it, another hit there. Reversal by Tyler Black.
And he dodges that one.
I mean, the stuff they're going to have to do to each other to win that match is going to be out of control. Oh, can't do anything. Never mind. Drop kick to the back. Swagger waiting. Swagger waiting. And I think Tyler Black knows this. Oh, he ran right into a punch there. Oh!
Kick.
Going for the legs of Tyler Black. This is what Swagger has to do, is keep the smaller man down here. Tyler Black is obviously the smaller man in this match, but it has not stopped him from becoming ECW World Heavyweight Champion two times. At the same time, Swagger's gonna have to use that and use that to his advantage, pretty much here. In the TLC match, there's not going to be any. No, there's going to be no disqualifications. There's going to be no. Oof, that was nasty. There's going to be no. No pinfalls, no submissions, none of that stuff. So, I mean, it's going to be really rough and really hard for maybe Swagger to get anything done here. But right now, Swagger's going for the ankle lock here. I mean, you saw him go an attack. You saw him going to attack Tyler Black's legs a minute ago. And Tyler Black trying to go for the rope, and he got the rope.
I guess he wants to try something else. I don't know what more you'd want to do to another man.
Big time side suplex, belly to back suplex. Now Swagger again going for the legs here, the calf killer, he might have it. Look at him wrenching back on Tyler Black's fucking spine there with that leg. Tyler Black reverses it, amazing. Standing shooting star press. Look at this. Hook, fish hook suplex, going for the pin here. And only a zero. Oh! Look at this suplex. He got all of it. How the Black looking set up for something big. Oh, Swagger fighting back here to stay in this one here. Swagger going to the top. Something you don't see from Swagger. Oh! Stalking his prey here, pretty much Swagger is. Smart man! Oh, and he ran right back! You saw the lunge that he went for. Going to take down. Oh! Tyler Black's legs there. And Tyler Black. Oh, right back into it. Lift and reverse. Oh! The hell?
I'm not sure if he knows. Incoming!
Oh! Oh, reverse line. I think Tyler Black was setting up Swagger for that. I don't think he really thought about how far he had to go with it. But either way, Swagger with getting his bearings back, even momentarily, big time wrestling esque. Suplex there, or a slam. Very amateur wrestling style of Jack Swagger. Oh! Drop kick, taking him down again. Tyler Black now going to take advantage here. And if he can get this move, he's definitely gonna beat Swagger again. Oh! And Swagger again! Found a way, somehow, some way. And, oh, Olympic slam. Going for the pin. Is it enough here? 1, 2, 3. And Jack Swagger with the victory over Tyler Black. That was out of control.
And here's some highlights from the matchup.
And we saw there Tyler Black got himself back into it. And at points, it seemed like Tyler Black could have won this whole match. You see the wrestling slam, the amateur style that has beaten so many men before Tyler Black. And that Olympic slam did all the work right there. And that is how you do it.
You have to like this display. Well, I like the display, but I don't know how much trust there is in the ring.
Mind you this, these two were somewhat at a mutual agreement, regardless of how much you might hate Tyler Black. We saw a month or two ago, Jack Swagger save Tyler. Jack Swagger saved Tyler Black from CM Punk, and now it seems like that loss may have changed the way that Tyler Black's thinking about going into this championship match. Mind you, it's a TLC match, so any man could win this somehow, some way. I say Tyler Black has this one in the bag, but then again, Jack Swagger could come out and with a big-time victory. We'll find out who wins that, though. ACW presenting TLC this Sunday on pay-per-view. Don't you dare miss it, because it's coming up next. Anyways, as always, guys, comment, like, subscribe. Be ready for ECW TLC, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Until then, peace out, and good shit.